Welcome to Dell Technologies RecoverPoint for Virtual Machines 5.3 How-To Series. Prerequisites for a successful RecoverPoint for Virtual Machines upgrade. Reference Dell Knowledge Article Number 19482. This video was created to perform a successful upgrade of RP4 VM. Successful upgrade of RP4 VM will prevent a series of unwanted conditions like DRU, data replication unavailable, delay on NDU, non-disruptive upgrade, completion, or more serious issues as necessity to reinstall the whole environment. This video presents the following conditions to be met before performing an upgrade. Principal known issues that can be encountered during an upgrade, and workaround to prevent it. Correct sequence of steps to be performed during the upgrade. When to do this. Before performing the RP4 VM upgrade, always refer to this KB to perform all necessary pre-check and preemptive workaround for known issues. Before you begin, have Virtual Center Administrator credentials. Have VRPA admin root credentials. Have ESXi root credentials. Have HTTPS, SSH connectivity to the VRPA. Have HTTPS connectivity to Virtual Center. Have SSH connectivity to the ESXi, in the cluster which is hosting the VRPAs. Pre-check and preemptive workarounds. Demonstration. Verify vCenter and ESXi versions. Log into vCenter with administrator credentials. Ensure vCenter version is 6.5 or later, or 6.7U1. Click on the question mark on the top right corner, and select About VMware vSphere. Confirm the vSphere client version later than 6.5 or 6.7U1. Ensure ESXi are at minimum version of 6.5. Select Host and Cluster from vSphere left panel. Then select the cluster with the ESXi host you need to check. For each host, select Summary and review the hypervisor version. Demonstration. Ensure that the security level of the RecoverPoint cluster is set to not authenticated nor encrypted, or authenticated and encrypted. Log in as admin on RPA, CLI. Select Option 2 Setup. Then Option 8, Advanced Options. Two Security Options. Six Change Appliance Communication Security Level. If the default level is not authenticated and encrypted, or not authenticated and encrypted, proceed changing it to one of these two levels, and repeat for all other clusters connected. Demonstration. Ensure that Site Control RPA is RPA1. If you are upgrading to version 5.3.1 or later, this preemptive workaround can be skipped. Log in as admin on RPA1 CLI. Select Option 3 Diagnostics, then Option 1 IP Diagnostics, and Option 2 View IP Details. Confirm if the interface ETH column 1 is assigned to RPA1 or not. If not, reboot RPA2 to have the site control move to RPA1. Demonstration. Verify the presence of an old data structure present in replicated virtual machine. If you are upgrading to version 5.3.1 or later, this preemptive workaround can be skipped. Log in as admin on RPA CLI. Select Option 2 Setup. Then select Option 8, Advanced Options, and Option 4, Run Script. Copy and paste the signed script from KB180298, confirm with Enter, and add your name when requested, if the script outputs any VM names. Unprotect the VMs, and reprotect them. Demonstration. Ensure that RecoverPoint has an updated vCenter certificate. Log in as admin on RPA CLI. Select Option 6, System Management CLI. Execute the command, Update vCenter Server Registration. And provide all information regarding RPA Cluster vCenter address and credential as requested. Reference the following for more information. Knowledge Base Article 173920 182 337 173 921 173 584 180 298 and 180 423. Thank you for watching.